One of my favorite parts of collecting comic books is making custom-bound hardcovers. Hardcovers are a great way of getting the material in a very durable package that's really easy to pull off the shelf and read. This video is for those who are new to the process to help explain the nuances and details that go into creating the perfect collection of your books, made exactly to your preferences and specifications. There are many places that offer binding services. My personal favorite is Houchen Bindery. This video will detail the process of working with them, but the principles of binding are universal, and this information will apply to other binders as well. There are three main types of binding used: glue binding, oversewn binding, and smythe sewn binding. With glue binding, the issues or trade paperbacks are pulled together and laid on a glue base. The benefit of this is it's really easy to split up, reorder, remove parts, add something like the table of contents. However you want the contents to lay out, it's up to you. It's a very, very flexible process, and it's actually what's used to create commercial trade paperbacks you'll find on the shelf at your local comic shop. This also means that if you wanted to combine multiple trade paperbacks into one volume, this is the method you need to use. At Houchen, they use two types of glue, DFAB and pure binding.
DFAB happens to be their cheapest option, but it works great. Pure is capable of adhering to glossy finishes, so if your comics have that, use this glue.
The only disadvantage to this method is that there is some gutter loss. The gutter is on the inside of the book where the pages meet the binding. Both glues can accommodate about 25 issues or 2 inches thick. With oversewn binding, the books are sewn through many, many times, which creates an extremely durable spine. Gutter loss is similar to that of the glue bindings, and similar size limits apply.
Smythe sewn binding is my personal favorite. This only works with single issues of comics that have a stapled spine. The staples are removed and the issues are sewn through the spine. This creates an extremely durable spine that opens 100%, preventing any gutter loss.
The major downside to this method is that you can't rearrange your issues. Each issue needs to remain intact, more or less how it was originally published, with the folded spine. This method works best if kept to about 18 to 20 issues per volume. There are a few choices you need to make about how the paper is treated. The first is easy. Do you want your book trimmed?
Often books can be subtly sized differently. And on top of that, the process of binding them can introduce some tiny shifts in alignment. Choosing this option means that once the books are initially bound together, they are put in a press to cut the edges and make them uniform. This will take off a small amount of material, typically less than a 16th of an inch, but the benefit is that your pages come out uniform. You also get to choose the shape of your spine. You can have it square or rounded. This is purely a personal aesthetic choice. Neither option affects stability.
There are two routes you can go for the exterior of your book: a cloth buckram cover or a printed graphic cover.
You've seen buckram covers before, at libraries, at schools, places where books are ready to take a beating. You can choose from a wide array of colors too, so that it stays on theme with the books inside. You also have a lot of power over the lettering on the outside of the book. Along the spine, you will likely put the title of the book and author, which is something you specify on the order sheet you're putting together. The other option you have is for a graphic cover. Rather than cloth, a binder will print out an image on heavy paper, laminate it, and use that to cover the boards. This can be designed by you, a friend, or the binder themselves. This gives a really great look to your books and can fool you into thinking you bought it from your local shop.
Getting your books ready for binding is a fairly straightforward process. The biggest task is to make sure that the issues are in the correct order that you want them bound. If you want any material removed from the books, you can either remove it yourself or make a note for the binder which pages to remove. You need to make sure that all of your comics have been removed from their bags and boards. What I like to do is to sandwich them between two boards and then stick the whole thing in a rubber band.
Then you slip in the order sheet, which will let the binder know exactly how you want this put together.
I always recommend going to your local comic shop and asking if you can have any of the boxes that Diamond uses for shipping comics to the stores. They're very durable and are made to the exact size of comic books, so it offers a lot of protection. And those are the basics. That first bind can be a very daunting process, but trust me, it does get easier. What I would also recommend is that you don't start off with your absolute favorite run. Start off with something else, learn what your personal tastes are, and then get to your favorite. Trust me, once you get there and it's to your absolute perfection, you'll love it.